A child has only three purposes in life: to be loved, to learn, and to contribute. But what if from those days you were born, you find yourself abandoned and dumped like trash at a dark alley, with stray dogs and cats, insects hovering over you? What if you were not even given a chance to survive? What if you were deprived of love and made an orphan?
Nama saya Suraya Abdul Razak. Saya adalah penjaga kepada Mariam. Mariam ni adalah baby girl yang pertama kelahiran dari rumah kita. So, anak perempuan sulung lah rumah kita ni. Mak dia bersalin di sini, datang sini masa usia kehamilan 7 bulan. And selamat melahirkan dia. Dan selepas 2 minggu, ibu dia keluar daripada sini dan tinggalkan Mariam di sini.
Baby abandonment, or better known as baby dumping in Malaysia, is also happening all over the world and is on a dramatic rise. As of 2019, it's been recorded that over 1,000 babies in Malaysia itself have been found dumped, with 64% of them found dead. And yet, some who were lucky to survive but made orphaned are now considered stateless and possibly deprived of proper education and a normal life. But among those, there are some who are blessed with a second chance for a change in their life. And one of them is my mother.
When I was at the tender age of 12, I learned that my mother herself was a victim of child abandonment. And though she never really showed signs of insecurities towards me and my family members at all, I couldn't help but question over the years on why her biological parents would even give her up in the first place. Learning and listening about her stories also made me question about things like, why would any parents be so heartless to give their child away? How could any mother bear to abandon her own flesh and blood? Was there no bond between mother and child? However, I am so, so thankful that she was adopted into a loving family that provided her with unconditional love and the most important tool in the world, education. Because of this, I made it my personal goal to provide as many abandoned children as possible an opportunity at a second chance in life. A chance to live in a world full of love and possibilities. And that was how Chance for Change was born.
Chance for Change, a project in collaboration with Orphan Care Foundation and Rumah Kita, with the objective to raise awareness, educate, and offer a chance for both babies and teen and unwedded pregnant mothers a new lease of life. A life where there is a sense of belonging, a world of love, and a hope of success. The project is executed into two different key areas. The first one being awareness. We reached out to teenagers and young adults at local schools to raise awareness on the consequences of unintended pregnancies, sexual health and safety, sexual grooming, identifying predators, and knowing the right time to say no to unwanted sexual activities. We also created fundraisers, such as this charity screening of Maleficent 2, and with this, we were provided the opportunity for us to communicate on the roots and issues around baby dumping to all our attendees. Public events like these are able to bring the issue to light so that more people understand the severity of it. The issue is appalling, but it is happening. There are news reports that highlight cases of Malaysian teen girls giving birth in school bathrooms and leaving the newborns among garbage or even flushed down the toilet itself. Some babies are even found swaddled in newspaper, crying in fly-infested dustbins, or placed on wet rice fields, exposed to the harsh sun, or even stuffed in a plastic bag. While some are not even able to see a day in this world, there are also babies born with physical disabilities, mentally unsound, or from substance abuse dependent mothers and fathers. So this little precious girl here, her name is Orchid. She was actually found in a forest to both drug addict parents. A year ago when I first started visiting this place, I actually saw Orchid being completely bedridden. And I remember that she couldn't even move any of her limbs. She couldn't move her head. She couldn't move anything at all. She was completely so quote unquote disabled. After several attempts and several visits to the acupuncture center, she is now able to move. And look at her, she's so sweet. What was that?
And then there are also babies who are born out of wedlock or rape victims with their mothers frowned upon by society. And because of this, I've learned to be more compassionate, especially to ladies who may have unwillingly became mothers, such as this young girl.
Masa saya umur 15, ayah saya bawa saya dekat rumah lagi satu. Rumah tu rumah lelaki tu lah. So, saya tak tahu kenapa kena pergi situ. So, ayah saya tu kata, ni kena kahwin dengan lelaki ni. Macam, kenapa? Saya so, kena kahwin. Ni hal masa depan awak. Sampai benar-benar menangis, saya tak nak. Saya tak nak tapi, terpaksa juga saya kahwin dengan dia. Dalam masa seminggu dengan lelaki tu, saya lari. Saya rasa macam stres gila. Saya tak tahu nak buat apa-apa. Dia call, ayah saya call, balik. Suruh balik. Saya kata saya tak nak kalau laki tu ada lagi, saya tak nak balik. Kalau saya kalau ayah kahwin saya lagi, saya takkan datang sini dah. Saya takkan datang balik dekat ayah balik. Lepas tu dia kata, okey janji tak buat lagi. Okey tak apa, dalam masa seminggu, ayah saya kahwin, kata saya lagi sekali. So dua kali lah saya kahwin. Saya dah kata dah, ini last. Saya datang, saya balik. Ayah dah kahwin saya lagi sekali, so saya takkan balik lagi. So saya lari. Saya rasa macam tak sangka ayah sendiri yang paksa saya, jual saya macam tu. Saya pun tak tahu kenapa. Saya macam sasak. Kalau jumpa dia pun macam tak nak tengok muka dia, memang benci sangat. Tak nak buat apa.
More often than not, child abandonment is also caused by poverty and homelessness from parents who lack the resources or financially incapable of taking care of their child. And that's where the second part of our project comes in, sustainability.
Hello everyone, so today we're here at Rumah Kita and what we're doing is that we're creating a sustainable source of income for the mothers who are living here. So what we're doing today is really, really exciting because we have people come in and teach them how to do jewelries from earrings to bangles to even just accessories in general. Right now, they're actually doing the bracelets that we will be selling very, very soon, both online and as well as charity bazaars. I can't wait. They're in the midst of doing it right now. So yeah, let's go see it.
I hope with this project, more lives over the years will be impacted. And the main goal is to break this vicious cycle once and for all. In life, we may choose to let issues go, let it disappear, and go by unnoticed. But this is where we are wrong. Nothing goes by unnoticed. So let's work together in the hope that more babies live a meaningful life and more opportunities for those mothers to regain control of their own lives as well. Spread the hope, save the judgments, because everyone deserves a chance for change.